Everyone, in this tutorial I am going to talk about the graphical interface, graphical user interface, GUI. And for this you need a C compiler which has graphics, or you can go to lab windows, search in Google and use lab windows, which has a very good and compatible graphical user interface, and you can download and get a 30 days trial. And after that, if you are pleased with the program, you can purchase. I am going to program and start National Instrument Lab Windows CVI. And in this you have open or new project and examples, but you can choose between projects that you can write only usual C program, but you are going to select a project from template and user interface application and project name. I am going to use the example, or maybe example, and I am going to change the folder. Change the folder to GUI and select the folder, and it's going to make example.prj, which is a project, and we are going to only select OK. You don't need to check add this project to the current workspace, only use OCO and the program starts. And at in the left you have a project tree which calls example, and it automatically starts an user interface graphical file, and also it also automatically starts an example.c. in this UIR file, the program automatically make a panel, and in this panel you can right click and you have a lot of components you can use it. The numerical components, it is a numerical control. It is numerical that you can select a scroll and select a few any number. You have a thermometer that you can change the thermometer manually. You have a tank that you can change the volume. And you have a slider, a vertical slider or horizontal slider, and you have knob, dial, you have jug and meter. And then you have a text, which is string only, and you have a text message, and you have a text box. You have a command button, UCO or image, and toggle button, also a square button, square push button. You have a off button. You have a radio button. You have a square radio button. You have a checkbox. You have a LED, a round LED or a square LED. You have binary switch on off, vertical or horizontal. You have rings that you can put different items and choose the items in your when you run your program. And it is menu ring, it is recessed menu ring, and it is pop-up menu ring. You have a vertical slider to the horizontal slider, knobs and jog and meter. You have a tank here, you have a thermometer also, and you have list and tables. You have a list box, you have a tree, and you have a table. You have decorations that you can gather your components in one place and delete. You have graphical, you have a graph, strip chart, or digital graph. You have a picture that you can import your images. You have timer. You have canvas that you can draw your own graphics. You have a splitter, vertical splitter, horizontal splitter. You have a tab. You have a ArchiveX and the classic. You have all those things here too. But sometimes you can find more, and you can use another component in this. And custom controls, you can have a different 3D graph, animation control, and so on. And you have a menu bar too. Okay, it is when you see in the C part, it has automatically included the header files, which is compatible. It has also started the example.h, and toolbox is important that you have include toolbox, which is necessary for all those components. And you have a static integer hand, panel handle, which is this one. And in the main program, it has automatically used important codes, and it is very good to have this. And the panel has been already checked. And when you are going here, it is codes, and it is generate all codes, main function, callbacks or panel. When you use generation, it appeared the header file example.h header file in this tree. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial when we are going to start our project.